Okay, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we will be having our lecture number 10 that is about machining operation and machine tools. Let me share my screen. Okay, chapter number 22, machining operation and machine tools. In this lecture, we will be having some topics like turning and related operation, drilling and related operation. Then we will move toward millings, then machining centers and turning centers, other machining operation and high speed machining. This table of content for this chapter. Now we will define machining as that is a material removal process in which a sharp cutting tool is used to mechanically cut away material so that desired part geometry remains. So in this type of process, we have a sharp cutting tool, and with the help of that sharp cutting tool, we remove extra material from the from your base material in order to get your desired part geometry. So most common application of this machining process is actually to shape the metal parts. You will have metal parts and you are going to shape them by removing the extra material from that metals so that you can get your part geometry. So that is why machining is most versatile and accurate of all machine manufacturing process in its capability to produce this diversity of parts and geometric features such as screw, thread, grays, teeth, flat surfaces. So it is also known as most versatile and accurate all machining processes. You can have you can give shapes to various metals and we have different processes for them. Up till now we have studied that bulk deformation process, sheet metal process, casting, and in casting you have discussed many processes. All the processes were used to shape the metal parts. So machining is also a shaping operation in which you remove extra material with the help of sharp cutting tool in accurate of all the processes. That is why we know that this machining operation is a versatile manufacturing processes. Casting can also produce, but it lacks the precision and the surface finish is not good, and it further required machining operations in order to get your precise and accurate precision and accuracy of machining. And further machining is required in order to get your final shape. Now we have classified the machine parts on the basis of their shape. The first one is rotational and the second one is non-rotational. Now rotational part are those parts which are cylindrical or distribution of part. For example, if you are performing turning and boring, these are rotatable parts that are cylindrical or disc type shape. We have other than cylindrical or disc like shape part that are known as non rotational parts, and they are also known as prismatic part. Non-rotational part is also known as prismatic parts. For example, these are block-like or plate-like shapes, and they can be achieved by linear motion. Motion is achieved of the work part. You can perform milling operation, shape and planning, while in this you can perform in this not rotational part, you can perform traditional or non-rotational, that is shown over here. So this is a rotational part and this is non-rotational part or prismatic part. Now machining operation and part geometry. Now machining operations are performed using a sharp cutting tool which removes the extra material from the workpiece, and the workpiece will get the part shape that you are going to produce. Now this shape is generated due to two factors. The first one is relative motion between tool and workpiece. So, now if you remove the material with the help of cutting tool, so the first factor that is necessary is that there should be a relative motion between tool and work part. If both are if both are moving, then it will definitely cut the material. If one is stationary and another is moving, it will also cut the material. But and if both are stationary, then you know that no cutting will be possible. So each machining operation produces a characteristic part geometry due to two factors. The first one, that there should be a relative motion between tool and work part. If there is no relative motion between tool and work part, then no machining operation can be performed. And the second one is shape of cutting tool. Now, machining is also possible due to the shape of cutting tool. So, the first one, that is relative motion between tool and work part, is also known as generating, because in this generating, what is actually the definition of generating is that generating is the production of parts in which part geometry is determined by the feed trajectory of cutting tool. So in this type of parts, the shape or part geometry of the workpiece is determined by the feed trajectory of cutting tool. So feed, it is totally dependent on feed trajectory. Now what is feed trajectory? Feed trajectory means that the path followed by the cutting tool. So what will be the path followed by the cutting tool? It will be exactly the shape given will be given to the part. So part geometry is determined by the feed trajectory of cutting tool. कहने का मकसद ये है कि जो cutting tool, जिस तरह आप cutting tool को motion देते हैं, तो जो path follow करता है, वही shape जो है वो object पे आती है. That this process is known as generating. Feed motion creates shape. For example, जिस तरह आप straight turning करते हो, taper turning, straight turning में आप tool जो है that is parallel to the axis of rotation of workpiece. While in taper turning, either the tool is at certain angle to the workpiece, or workpiece at certain angle to the tool, and profile milling. So all this example of generating. Now in all this example, the shape of the part geometry is determined by the feed trajectory of cutting tool. The second one is shape of cutting tool. अच्छा दूसरा जो आपके पास जो machining operation की shape जो बनती है, एक तो आपके पास due to part trajectory of feed part trajectory of cutting tool ki wajah se shape banti hai. The second one, it can be due to the shape of cutting tool, that is known as forming. Now forming is a machining operation in which part geometry is created by the shape of cutting tool. To jo aapke paas cutting tool ki shape hogi, that will be imparted to the part. So cutting edges has the reverse of the shape of to be produced on the part surface. Iski example kya hai? X form turning, drilling and broaching, all these are the example of forming operation. So basically main repeat kar dun ki hamare paas shape jo hai kisi bhi geometry, part geometry ki, wo do cheezon ki wajah se hai, generating ya forming. Ab generating kya hai? Generating is the shape that is achieved due to a feed trajectory of cutting tool, while forming mein hai part geometry is created by the shape of cutting tool. Achha. We have some process which is the combination of forming and generating, and forming and generating are sometimes combined in one operation, such as in thread cutting on lathe and slot milling. So you can see that this is a turning operation. This is the feed trajectory of the cutting tool. So that is simple turning operation. This is taper turning operation. So this is the profile or the path followed, tool followed this path. So all these are example of, this is a profile milling. So all these are the example of generating operations. Now here, these are all the example of forming operation. You know that this is a form tool which have the same shape as imparted to the parts. So drilling operation, that same shape is imparted to the part, and broaching operation you can see. So in this type of operation, the shape of the tool is imparted to the workpiece. Now this is the example of combination of forming and generating operation. So you can see thread in threads, this the tool follow the path as well as the shape of the tool is imparted to the workpiece. So this is the example of combination of forming and generating operation. So similarly here, the tool cutter or T slot miller cutter will follow this path as well as this shape. You can see that is projected is imparted to the work part. So that is the combination of forming and generating operation. Now, what is turning operation? The first basic operation. Now, turning operation is that type of operation in which a single point cutting tool removes material from a rotating workpiece to generate a cylindrical shape. So basically that this process is used to produce a cylindrical shape. So what happened in this process is that you have a sharp single point cutting tool, and that tool is fit linearly in direction parallel to the axis of rotation. So you can see that this is the workpiece that is rotating, for example, and you have a single point cutting tool. Now this is the axis of rotation, and the tool is fit parallel to the axis of rotation, and that will give you a cylindrical surfaces. So that type of operation is known as turning operation. So that is performed on a machine that is known as lathe machine. Various other operation that can be performed on lathe machines are facing, contour turning, chamfering, cutoff, threading. We will see in next slide. Okay, I will discuss this after a few minutes, because this there will be a problem associated with this topic. So we will see in a while. Now the type facing. Now in facing operation is that type of operation in which tool is fed inward, radially inward toward the axis of rotation, and by doing so it will create a flat surface at the end. So this type of operation is known as facing operation. Contour turning. Now what is mean by contour turning? Contour turning is that type of turning that in which a tool is follow a contour path. Instead of following this axis parallel to this axis, now tool will follow up this contour, and by following this contour the shape will be like that. So basically this is a generating process, but actually this is contour turning operations too. Instead of feeding the tool parallel to the axis of rotation, tool follow a contour that is other than straight, thus creating a contour. So this type of turning operation is known as contour turning. Chamfering. Now chamfering is cutting edges cuts an angle on the corner of cylinder, forming a chamfer. So you can see that at the edge you can cut it in order to have this cut edge, so that sharp edges may be provided. So cutting edges cuts an angle on the corner of the cylinder, producing a chamfer. So this is a chamfer operation. Cutoff. Now cutoff is actually you are going, if you want to cut your cylindrical part at certain length, so you will perform cut operation. So in this type of cutting operation, the tool is fed linearly inward toward the center. So the tool is fed linearly toward the center. When it approaches to a center, so a part is cut it. So tool is fed inward into rotating work at some location to cut off end of the part, and this process is also known as parting. And the tool that is used to perform parting operation is known as parting tool. Threading. This is another type of operation related to turning operations. That is, in threading operation, a single point tool, form tool. Then now. Form tool means that the tool shape will be imparted to the part. So pointed form tool is fed linearly across surface of rotating part parallel to the axis of rotation, large feed rate, thus creating threads. So you have a forming tool and you are going to feed this tool at high feed rate and parallel to the axis of rotation, so it will create the threads. This operation is known as threading operation. Now this is a summary about the machining operation that is performed on lathe or machines. The first one is facing, we have discussed. The second one is taper turning. Now in taper turning, you are going, there are various methods that is used to perform taper turning operation. The first one is that the tool is at certain angle to the to the axis of rotation. Now in this example, the feed of the tool is at certain angle to the axis of rotation. If you project this feed, so it will make angle with the axis of rotation. So that is creating a tapered part. Contour turning, the tool follow a contour, thus creating a contour surface. Form turning, now in form turning you have a form tool and that is attached with the workpiece, creating a shape to this cylindrical workpiece. So that process known as form turning. Chamfering, you can see that corner edge, cut it with the help of cutting tool. The cutoff methods are parting, in which you are going to cut the part at certain length. Threading operation, the boring operation can be performed on lathe machine. You have this boring tool attached with a cylindrical rod. Now this tool is either the tool will rotate or the workpiece will rotate. There will be a relative motion between them, so it will remove the material from inside, thus it will enlarge the existing hole. Drilling operation can be performed on lathe machines. So you have a drill tool that is used and your workpiece will be rotating and it will create a hole. Knurling is also another machining operation that is performed on lathe. You have a knurl tool that have hatches on the surface and it is pressed against this workpiece that is rotating at high speed, so it will create the same pattern on the surface of the workpiece, and this is used for gripping purpose. So all these are the operation that are on the lathe machine. Now engine lathe, most of you know about this engine lathe. I will not take too much time on that. So we have this portion that is known as head stock, the tail stock. This is a hole known as carriage. Now in carriage you have tool post. This is a cross slide. The tool can be moved cross. This hole is known as carriage. You have ways that can, this carriage can be slide linearly on this ways. You have lead screw that is also attached with this carriage, and that is used for automatic feed or for creating threads. You have feed control buttons through which you can control the feed rate, and you have speed control through which you can control the speed of this chuck. All these were discussed in lab courses and most of you are aware from there. So kindly go through this. If you have any question, you can ask. This is the cross slide, some portion of carriage. That is a cross slide. This is a tool post. This is compound dress method, and through which you can make the your cutting tool at angle. So by this by this handle, this cutting tool can be moved cross. And this is threaded dials. Now most lathe machines are horizontal, but vertical lathe machines are also used for job with large diameter relative to the length and for heavy work. So normally this small machine are used for smaller diameter and longer length workpiece. But for, if you have a bulky heavy work having larger diameter and smaller length, for that purpose we have vertical lathe machines. Maybe you have seen in industry while you are internship in that industries or any plants, you have seen this vertical lathe machines. So now whenever you are going to select a lathe machine, there are two parameters that are necessary for selecting this lathe machine. So the size of lathe machine is designated by swing and maximum distance between this center. So these are the two parameters that are designated while you are going to buy a lathe machine. So you must know about swing and maximum distance between center. Now what is swing? Swing is the maximum diameter of the work part that can be mounted on the spindle or that can be rotated in the spindle. So swing is maximum what part diameter that can be rotated in spindle. And the second one is distance between the center, indicates the maximum length of the workpiece that can be mounted between headstock and tailstock. So you must know about swing, you must know about maximum distance between the centers. So now this is example 350 mm into 1.2 meter. Now what does it mean? Now this 350 mm is the swing. Now this 350 mm is the swing means that maximum 350 millimeter diameter of power part can be mounted on this lathe machine, and maximum 1.2 meter length of work job can be mounted on this. So this 350 mm by 1 into 1 by 2 lathe means that a swing of 350 millimeter and maximum distance between center of 1.2 meter can be mounted on this lathe machine for work. So these are the two basic parameters. Now methods of holding work in the lathe. So we can hold our workpiece in lathe by using different methods. These are the methods that are given below. Holding the workpiece between the center, you can have tailstock and headstock, and in between these two centers you can hold the workpiece. You have chuck. By using chuck you can hold the workpiece. By collet you have a special arrangement that is used to hold the cylindrical workpiece, that is collet, and a face plate is also used to hold the workpiece. There is another term that is missing in this slide and that is available in book is dog plate, and with the help of dog plate you can also hold the workpiece. All these are discussed in this coming next slides. Now holding the workpiece between the center. Now in this example you can see that they have given this is the dog plate. You can see that this is a dog plate, and that is used to hold this the workpiece. And in this slide they have also discussed that holding between the center. So there is a one center in the headstock, tailstock, and at one center at the headstock. So you can hold the workpiece between the center. Also you can use the dog plate for holding the workpiece. So this is one method that is holding between the center, and another method using dog plate is also discussed over here. So mounting the workpiece between the center using a dog appropriate for part with larger length to diameter ratio. If you have a workpiece that have higher length to diameter ratio, means length is high and diameter is small, so length to diameter ratio will be high. So in that case you can use these methods. The tailstock center can be either live or dead. By live or dead means the live center is the headstock center and dead center is the tailstock center, and you know that. Now chuck. There is another method that is used to hold the workpiece is by means of chuck. So you have three jaws, self-centered chucks. You can see that there is a one jaw, two jaw, and there is another third jaw that is not visible in this picture. So all these jaws can be can move toward the center or out of the center simultaneously. That's why these are three jaws are dependent on each other. If you are going to move this jaw with the help of key, so all these other jaws will also move with this jaw. That is why this is known as three jaw self-center check. They are adjustable automatically in order to claim the work. So three jaw chuck can we can also have four jaw chuck. So a self-centering chuck has a mechanism to move the jaws in or out simultaneously, thus center the work at the spindle axis. So these jaws move simultaneously and it will automatically center the work at the spindle axis. These are used for holding the cylindrical workpiece. We have collet that is also used for holding the workpiece. You can see that this is the collet. This is the this portion is known as this is actually collet that have three slits. Means this is one portion, this is two portion, and this can be slightly open and you can insert the workpiece in this all it. And there is a sleeve that can be slide on this collet. If once you enter the workpiece in this collet, you can then advance forward it to squeeze the collet. Actually, this the sleeve is used to squeeze this collet, thus holding this workpiece. So collet is a tubular bushing with the longitudinal slits running over half its length and equally spaced around its circumference. So you, by this method, you can also hold the workpiece. Now faceplate. The faceplate is also used to hold the workpiece. Now what is difference between chuck and faceplate is that in chuck you can hold the cylindrical workpiece or rotational workpiece, while in faceplate you are going to hold the non-rotational or prismatic part. So this in this faceplates, all these jaws are not dependent on each other. They can operate individually. So the faceplate is equipped with custom design clamps for particular geometry of the parts. So you can have different adjustment for each jaws. So they are not dependent on each other. That's why they are known as four jaws independent chuck. Other lathe and turning machines. We have other turning machines developed to satisfy particular function or to automate turning. These are tool room lathe, speed lathe, turret lathe, checking machine, automatic screw machine, numerical control lathes. So I'm not going to discuss these types. Kindly go yourself in these slides or in book and read that what are the function of this machine. Basically, the function that is discussed earlier in these slides are same performed on these machines, but they have different construction and their capacity. So you can have, this is a capstan lathe machine, you can say that is why that is known as turret lathe. You have a turret, hexagonal turret in which six different tools can be mounted. You have square turret, you have four different tools can be mounted over here. That is why it is turret lathe. You have seen in your lab, that is capstan lathe machine. Example of this turret, this is a turret having different cutting tools mounted on this turret. Chucking machine, bar machines, automatic screw, multiple spindle. So these, you can see the different tools, six different tools available, spindle. And according to your operation, this spindle moves and cutting tools available for subsequent machining operations. So the computer numerical control lathe machines. You have also gone through this or have seen these machines that is totally computer based. In this lathe machine, you have G codes and M codes, and based on these G code and M codes, it performs the machining operation and give you the final part geometry. Now, coming toward the things that that was skipped. Is this topic that is this operation. Now coming toward this topic that is available in your book, I will share the book with you. Let me share the book. Share my entire screen. Now in here, let me. Now this is the major topic, that is cutting condition in turning. Now you can see that you have this part, cylindrical part having initial diameter D naught, and turning operation is performed with the help of cutting tool. Now this cutting tool cut the material from this point and reach toward this point. After cutting, the material diameter is reduced to DF. Now basically, actually, the turning operation is that type of operation in which single point cutting tool is fed linearly parallel to the axis of rotation, thus creating a cylindrical surface and diameter is reduced from larger to smaller. So you can see this was the initial diameter D0 and this is the final diameter DF, and this is the rotation of the spindle. Now this D is the depth of cut that is given to the tool, and this depth, due to this depth, the material is cut and the diameter is reduced to DF. So total length L is the length of the workpiece. This is single point cutting tool, and this is chip that is generated due to cutting operation, and this F is the feed, and this is the velocity, cutting velocity. Now we will discuss the cutting condition topic over here. If you are aware of these parameters, so we will go toward the defining this parameter. Now the rotational speed N is generally represented by the equation N is equal to V over pi D naught. As we know that this linear velocity is equal to N pi D naught, where, and this rotational speed of the chuck N is given by the formula N is equal to V over pi D naught, where V is the cutting speed and D is original diameter, and N is the rotational speed having units revolution per minute. So V is the cutting speed having unit meter per minute or foot per minute or centimeter per minute, etc., depending upon the units given in your problems or in parameters. D naught is the original diameter that may be in millimeter or foot, depending on the type of unit system used. The turning operation reduces the diameter of work from its original diameter to final diameter DF. Now this was the original diameter D naught, and this is the DF. Now the formula for final diameter is DF is equal to D naught minus 2D. How you know that this is the D naught, okay, and this is DF, and this is D, cutting depth D. So if you give the depth D and in turning operation, as the workpiece is rotating, so it will also remove the material from this part. So you can see that this D naught is equal to DF plus D plus D, means that D naught is equal to DF plus 2D. So if you take DF, so DF will be equal to D naught. This DF will be equal to D naught minus D minus D, that is 2D. So DF will be equal to D naught minus 2D, that is given by the formula. So DF is equal to D naught minus 2D. Now you have feed that is given over here. This feed is the is defined as F, and it's having unit feed. Feed unit is millimeter per revolution. Now what does it means that in one revolution of chuck, if a chuck rotates one revolution, that it will, the tool will move toward this direction in millimeters. So the feed unit is millimeter per revolution. So for here you will have feed, the value of feed. Now this feed will be converted into feed rate. I will tell you why you are going to convert this feed into feed rate, but let first see that the feed in turning is generally expressed in millimeter per revolution. So this feed can be converted into a linear travel in millimeter per minute, because here we are going to find the time required for this turning operation. So for that purpose, you have to convert this feed into feed rate, and for that we have formula. This feed rate FR is equal to NF. If you multiply the rotational speed of the chuck with feed, you will get feed rate. So FR is the feed rate having unit millimeter per minute, N is the rotational speed having unit millimeter per minute or minute per minute, meter per minutes, and F is the feed rate having unit millimeter per revolution. Now up till now we have discussed this thing. Now we are going to find the time required for machining operation. So you must be know that you have this part, that and you are going to perform turning operation. So you must know that how much time will be required for this machining operation. So basic, generally the basic formula of for this turning operation is TM is equal to L over FR, whereas L is the length of the workpiece and feed is the FR is the feed rate. So if you have L, you have FR, you will put, because L will have unit in, for example, if L is in millimeter, so feed rate will be also in millimeter per minute. So millimeter will cut, and this will give you the time in minutes, where TM is the machining time, L is the length of cylindrical work part. So now this formula can be further simplified by, if you put the value of FR, which is NF for air here, and also put the value of N, which is pi V over pi D naught. So you will get another formula, that is TM is equal to pi D naught L over VF. So you can either use this formula or this formula. But if you have simple L and FR, so use this formula. But if you have do not have any FR value, so you, and you have these values, so you can use this formula. So one more thing, do not confuse yourself with these formulas. These are the same. If you remember this, you can get this, because FR will be equal to NF. So you will have to put here NF, and you are, again, you have to put the value of N over here. And when you simplify it, you will get this same formula. So this was all about the topic cutting condition or the time calculation in turning operation. So what you can give the name of this topic is cutting condition in turning or time calculation in turning operation. Both are the same. So in this topic, we learned that how to calculate time for turning up. That is volumetric. This is actually define you how much volume of the material is removed per unit time. So this RMR, rate of material removal, is equal to VF into D, where V is the cutting velocity, F is the feed, and D is the depth of cut. So if you have this value, you can also calculate RMR, rate of material removal. So I think kindly go to problems that is available at last in the exercise and solve it for understanding. If, again, if you have any problem, you can ask. So let me show the problems. Okay, you can see that this is a cylindrical work part. Diameter, initial diameter is given, length is given, is to be turned in an engine lathe, cutting speed is given, feed is given, and depth of cut is given. So you have to determine the cutting time and metal removal period. So again, if you solve first 2-3 problem, you will be able to understand this topic. Again, if you have any question, you can ask me. So that was about today's lecture, lecture number 10. Thank you. Thank you so much.